I'm go. Hi. So welcome to this very quick presentation of this project called Terms of Service Didn't Read, which has a tagline, I've read and agree to the terms, is the biggest lie on the web, and we aim to fix that. Quick word about me. I'm Chris. I'm in project since 2016. I'm an activist. I work in civil rights, and now I'm a web developer. So first of all, who accepts terms of service without reading them? Yeah, I expected that. Basically, this is not great. It's not an optimal situation. We all agree on that because, well, you know, those terms of service are really important. And this was the goal of our project. Our project was to build a crowdsourced knowledge base on those terms of service. So not only that you'll be able to understand the terms of service that you are going to be accepting, but you can contribute also to that knowledge. A little bit like a huge Wikipedia on terms of service. It started in 2013 after CCC, and since then the project has been running in very, very different stages. But first of all, when we started was, the people that created the project decided, let's do this. So they did what usually we do. They opened a mailing list. It was a Google group, kind of a forum. They built a HTML, simple, plain HTML, CSS, JavaScript website and discussed on the forum. And on the discussion, they were putting all the data into JSON files, and the JSON file were uploaded to the service and to the website. And this was making the thing going. We also did a Kickstarter campaign back in 2013. We raised 20K. This was nice. It survived the project in 2016. But there is one problem. It doesn't really scale. Have you already tried scaling JSON files? Especially like handwritten JSON file, which was the case at that time. So it doesn't really work and it stalled the project for, let's say, a year or all. So somewhere in November 2016, in a bar, one friend told me, yeah, you know what, we need an app. So I did, well, it was like already 5 beers then. I was like, yeah, I don't know how to code. I'll just do it. I'll just do that. So that's what we did. The good thing about that is that we already had the analysis framework. So we already knew how we should analyze the terms of service. So how does it work? It's actually very, very simple. So first of all, we call a service like something like Facebook. We divide the terms of service of that service into what we call points. Points are a single unit of analysis of the terms of service. So, for example, can you erase your account? Do you need to use your real name? And so on and so on. Each point has an overall rating, and the overall average rating of all the points of the first service issues a class. And the class allows you to rate the service between those service protect your privacy to this service really doesn't care. And so what we do is that we basically rate service online services like we rate washing machines on their all ecological impact from class A to class E. Well, but we also have cases, we also have like more complex mathematical formulas, so we know that one point might be more important than another, and a case is a transcendent point towards different services, so we're sure that you get the point. It's not very easy to explain that in a 5 minute presentation. So what we did, we built that tool that we called Phoenix. We released an alpha version at the end of 2017. We were a team of 3 junior web developers who did that, and it worked. We raised again 20K in spring 2018 to sustain the development of the project, and we released a beta version in 2018. I forgot to say that this is a full open source volunteer based project. So let's say that we are still doing a lot of work on the side of that, but you know, it works. So this tool that allows us to analyze those services is working, it exists. And not only that we delivered, we also imported all the points that were already done in the previous stage of the project. So to give you an idea, we have around almost 3,000 points, over 500 services. Not all of them have a class on the actual website if you're gonna check, because not all terms of service are truthfully analyzed, but we have all of that. And the almost 800 users we have is our tool since June. And we also have a browser extension for Firefox, Chrome, Safari, one browser extension for Internet Explorer, which doesn't work. I'm speaking about the browser, not the browser extension. And we also feature in DuckDuckGo's privacy add-on. This is the add-on they released earlier this year. It blocks blockers and stuff, and we also there. And yeah, this is done as it's a full volunteer project and open source. You can fork it, you can change it, you can modify it. We have a blog. If you go on edit.tsdr.org, you'll see our amazing tool. If you're a designer and you want to give some time, it would be really cool because the design isn't great. We have an open collective if you want to support us as well. And yeah, I'll be super happy to answer your question if you have any more questions afterwards. Thank you very much.